Yeah, so we've just finished our pre-flight briefing where we've talked about safety procedures and frequencies and things like that. So everyone is aware of what we're going to do and where we're going to be doing it tonight. We've got our subject planes. They're getting ready right now, but we're prepping our photo platform. This is a Beechcraft Bonanza A36. And as you can see, we've removed the double doors on the side, which provides a pretty good space for the photographer to shoot out of. First thing that we're going to do is we're going to remove all the parts inside the aircraft that could possibly come loose in flight. We don't obviously want that to happen. These aircraft are actually allowed to fly without the doors off. We're well within our regulations. First thing that we do is we set up a harness, a hard point that the photographer can connect into. He's going to be wearing a harness like this. This is kind of an industrial type harness. We've got an emergency knife on this harness so that if we were in a situation where we had to get out of the aircraft really quickly on the ground, we could cut our way out of the harness. Just to keep the cameras inside the airplane, these will clip into a point on the camera, keep any cameras from exiting the aircraft. And that's about it. Once we get all this in, we'll check it over one more time. Then the photographer will get on board. He'll be using a headset like this. This is a headset that you see a lot of people that fly open cockpit airplanes. And he'll plug into the comms on the aircraft so that he can talk with the pilot. Between that and using hand signals, he'll direct the aircraft in the air once he gets airborne. This is the basic setup that I use for air-to-air photography. This is a 1DX Mark I and this is a 1DX Mark II. Primary lenses that I use for air-to-air photography are the 70-200. I also use a circular polarizer on it. I prefer Heliopan and B&W are kind of two brands that I like to use. But I always keep a circular polarizer on for air-to-air photography. And then we're gonna set that camera up for shutter priority. The aircraft we're shooting today is a two-bladed prop. So we need to slow down the shutter speed enough that each blade of the prop is making a 180-degree arc so we get that nice full prop disc. So I'm gonna start off probably shooting at about an 80th of a second, and then I'll dial that up if I think I can get away with it. But as soon as I start to see that prop breaking, then I'll dial it down a little bit and slow down the shutter speed. You know, the slower the shutter speed, the nicer you're gonna get that big prop disc. You're also gonna be obviously subject to some vibration. The other lens that I'll use a lot is this is the Canon 24-105. It's an image stabilized lens. Again, circular polarizer. This is the Heliopan. And I will take both bodies with me. Don't like to change lenses in the air simply because there's a lot of dust and debris that gets moving around back there. So I try to keep the lenses fixed to the bodies and not switch those out mid-flight. And of course I carry a multitude of cards with me because we'll need to switch those out. So as I mentioned before, AOPA's primary photography platform that we use most of the time is the A36 Bonanza. It's a great platform. It covers a broad range of aircraft that we can shoot from it. Everything from small single engine aircraft all the way up through business jets. But sometimes we need a different platform that can fly a little bit slower, or if it's unusually cold outside, and we want to protect the photographer and the rest of the crew. We also have at our disposal a Cessna 182. This is a little bit different than sort of your off-the-shelf 182s because you can see we've had these custom windows built in the side, and they're pretty simple. All you have to do is get in here and just open the windows up, and we can shoot both from this side and from the other side. And it makes for a really capable photography platform also.